night, thousands gathered at the Pierhead in Liverpool to celebrate one of the city's most famous sons, John Lennon. He died 10 years ago in New York when he was shot leaving his apartment. Had he lived, he'd have been 50 much later on this year. Now, on stage last night was a star-studded lineup of names, old and new, all paying tribute to the man many now regard as the greatest songwriter Britain has ever produced. Susie Grant reports.
Only Liverpool can fittingly pay tribute to one of its most famous sons. Born in 1940, John Lennon was raised here by his Aunt Mimi in what was then a war-torn city. By the early 60s, he was the driving force behind what was to become the world's most famous group. 10 years later, the Beatles went their own separate ways, leaving John free to concentrate on his solo career. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You like Kennedy, almost everyone can remember where they were the day John was gunned down outside his home in New York.
And so to mark the 10th anniversary of Lennon's death, the city of Liverpool, along with some of the biggest names in the rock business, is paying tribute in the best way they can with a concert of Lennon's songs.
Cyndi Lauper's version of Hey Bulldog set the pace for a host of stars paying tribute to the former Beatle.
For all the obvious reasons, but it's John Lennon, it's his music, it's for his charity, it's the music and the men.
I used to dance to the Beatles records when I was like 8, 9, 10. And yeah, they mean probably not as much to me, or John Lennon hasn't like influenced me as much as he would have other people, but I certainly think he was a great man, and this is a really worthy dedication.
The artists performed on a giant stage built under the shadow of the Liver Building, and they included Al Green, Joe Cocker, the Moody Blues, and many more.
Thoughts meander like the restless wind inside a letterbox. They tumble blindly as they make their way across the universe. Nothing's gonna change my world. 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 Sounds of laughter, shades of earth are ringing through my open views, inciting and inviting me. Limitless, undying love that shines.
Oh, I don't know about you, but I could have taken another couple of hours of that. Joining me now from the Manchester studio is Justin Hayward. Good morning.
Hi, morning.
How do you feel this morning? I imagine things ended a bit late last night.
Yeah, it was. Well, in fact, a lot of it's still going on. When I left the hotel, it was still going on.
I can imagine.
But I feel elated because I was just so proud to be part of it. It was the most wonderful spirit of an event like that that I've ever been to, and a real celebration.
I must say, watching it, as each artist came on doing a Lennon song, it just reminded you how many wonderful songs he wrote.
Every song was a winner. You know, you couldn't fail. There was no low spots, because every song just hit right home. And
was there any special reason you chose to do Across the Universe?
I think it really... Moody Blues was from that era as well. And Across the Universe, I think, was the first solo record that he ever made, which he did for the World Wildlife Fund, on a World Wildlife album. And then it was done later, I think, on Let It Be, and where Phil Spector remixed it and reworked it. But I just loved that song. It was a very beautiful song.
Mm-hmm. And where were you during the heyday of the Beatles? I know during some of it you were in the charts yourself, but I was just wondering how far back it all goes.
Well, really, you see, really, I mean, the Beatles go such a long way back, because a lot of people forget that the Beatles were a tremendous success up here in the north, and they were big stars here in Liverpool 2 years, maybe 18 months before they really made it in the rest of the world. And I think that change to making it everywhere else came about when they started writing their own songs. So I really started listening to them for real when they started writing their own songs from Love Me Do.
And that encouraged you to write your own too?
Absolutely. It opened the door. You see, up until then, all my heroes were American rock stars. And I hadn't really found a true British, you know, rock and roll hero until I heard John Lennon, and then he was the one.
Did Lennon stand out for you as the genius of the Beatles, or what?
I think he stood out as the leader of the whole generation. The Beatles as a whole, as the group, were obviously, as we all know, in the 60s, the leaders. But John Lennon was someone who took risks in with his songwriting, his private life, and what he stood for. And that's a tough thing to do in the music business. It's so easy to play safe. Mm. And I think every musician respected him for that. And he was the leader for all British musicians for at that time.
And do you have a personal memory of him?
Well, I met John a few times at just different places, different functions. It's hard to say that he had very many close friends, but I met him actually once at Abbey Road. I picked up Mike Pinder, our keyboard player, who was big buddies with the Beatles. And unbeknownst to me, they were recording Sgt. Pepper. I didn't know what it was going to be called, but they were doing these sessions. And I picked up Mike one day from the Abbey Road studios, and John came out and we had a little chat. He had a really dry, amazing sort of sense of humour, and very cutting, very truthful.
Oh, I wish we all had a memory like that. Justin Hayward, thanks very much for joining us today. And thanks very much for your contribution last night. It was well worth watching. It really was great.
Oh, glad I was there.
I'll bet. I wish I'd been. Thanks ever so much. Bye.
Bye.
Imagine...